Atwood Stadium. Atwood Stadium was the people's stadium. We didn't ask that Atwood Stadium be given to catering. We pay a park millage, county and city. Seemed like the millage that we pay could help take care of Atwood Stadium along with the fundraisers and people involved. I commend those commissioners or board members for Atwood Stadium. You know, we gave you, y'all gave them a piece of paper, could have put it in a frame. I mean, what's a frame? You know, we do a lot of things. It feels good and looks good, and it's politically. You know, but out of my heart, and I'm not saying that some of you don't appreciate it, I do appreciate the work that they did. So when it comes to tax abatements, I'm against it. If I'm fortunate to sit on the Flint City Council, you know, it ain't what you say, it's how you vote. I'm gonna vote against tax abatements. I want tax abatements for the residents of the city of Flint. I want tax abatements for those seniors out there that can barely meet ends meet. I want tax abatements for the working poor. That's who needs the tax abatement. Some of the board members, and God bless them, they don't even live in the city of Flint. But we're here. We're here day to day, struggling, trying to make these ends meet. And so I'm against it. I can stand and tell you what I'm against, what I'm for and what I'm against, and I'm against it. And I'm standing with the people. If you ask the people of the city of Flint, the residents, doesn't matter which ward, are they for tax abatement for downtown or tax abatement for them? It'll always be for the people. I never see on the north end, and we have funeral homes on the north end, on ML King, on different funeral homes. I never see in businesses, barbershops, beauty shops that's owned by residents of the city of Flint. Somehow those tax abatements and those zones never reach over there. I know you got some by the lake over there, so before you all shoot down that road. Remember, I've been here going on 40 years coming down here. Maybe if the north end was given tax abatements and obsolete district all this money, maybe they could have sustained. Who can sustain when you don't pay taxes? When you get influx of money comes in, like the Crim brought a lot of money in. Just like Back to the Bricks brought a lot of money into downtown, and you don't have to pay taxes on it. Just think if we got a lot of money and I didn't pay taxes on it, the IRS would be knocking at my door, wanting their fair share. We see the city of Flint going after those who did not have not paid city income tax. We're going after them. But yet, and these are citizens who can't afford it. Yet at the same time, we see the emergency financial manager, whatever he is, the dictator, whatever you want to call him, giving breaks to his friends. And if I was in city council, I know you don't vote on it, but when things come as relevant to the people of the city of Flint, I really would think about how I vote, and is it really in the best interest of the people that elected you, especially in your particular ward? Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Dumas.
Hello, my name is R.L. Mitchell, and I live on 3512 Mildred Street before this program called Blight blighted me out of my home and put me in another home. It then blighted out my whole neighborhood, Sims. I couldn't buy enough money to build my roof up. And I'm going to just, for the record, let you know I'm against that tax rebatement for we the people of Flint. And Scotty, welcome back to the council.
Hello, for the record.
Thank you, R.L. Chris.
Thank you. My name is Chris Del Morone, and I live in Flint, Michigan. And let me start off by saying I had the opportunity this last weekend to travel to Washington, D.C. for the 50th anniversary commemorating Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.'s I Have a Dream speech. And some of the themes from the different speakers over the weekend, some of the words that were used were justice, equality, fairness, opportunity, access. And what this abatement does is it again denies to the residents of the city of Flint all of these opportunities. And one might ask, well, how does that happen? And I say it happens when we take some of our money that should be going into our neighborhoods and we use it for the tear down of Genesee Towers. That's how it happens. And this is the same type of thing. The Capitol Theater is a great place. I've been in it over the years when it was a bar, when they showed movies. Many of you may remember Velma at the organ as she rose out of the pits playing the organ there. It was open for the Sesquicentennial. Just recently, it was open for Back to the Bricks. And I toured through that whole building. We went up into the upper balcony there and into the projectionist booth. We went down into the basement. At one time, there used to be a bowling alley down there. Simply amazing. I never knew that. There used to be a barber shop there. There were stalls in there where they used to bring in horses or different animals. I don't know if it was for plays or in what capacity. The building's been there a long time. It's in need of remodeling. But allow me to remind council and the emergency financial manager and others, our city is broke. We don't have the money. Now, how is it that we will give this group a tax abatement? And then we have people, not leaders, but people in leadership positions in Lansing who are proposing an income tax increase for the residents of the city of Flint. What is it that I'm not understanding? Once again, it's put on the backs of the people. How do you go to someone who is making minimum wage and say, you need to pay more in income tax because our city is broke, but yet we will give businesses and corporations a tax break. You pay more for garbage collection, but we will not charge the companies, the businesses in the city of Flint for waste collection. That's what's going on now. It's a sad day in our community. The board at the Atwood Stadium Authority did a great job. I mean, it allowed people to see Mark Ingram play there when he was in high school. I mean, such an outstanding opportunity for the community to see someone like that play with that talent. But I assure you, for the $33,000 that Kettering will pay for Atwood Stadium, and this is according to our local newspaper, there are many, many more people and organizations who would have paid much more for that. Amen. Now, the city of Flint is not in bankruptcy, but I guarantee you, if the city of Flint had been in bankruptcy and they had put Atwood Stadium up for sale, they certainly would have gathered more than $33,000 for that. It's a travesty what's going on in our community, and the people are paying for it. They're paying for it in higher water bills that carry down to Water Authority. I mean, is there a problem or what? They can't even get the bonds to build that right now, the money. They can't sell the bonds. I mean, taking on a project like that, you need to have the financing available and ready. That's one reason why it's taking so long to take down Genesee Towers, because the financing wasn't there. I even go so far as to say, that's why the route was changed this year for the Bobby Crimm 10-mile road race. So it would not have to go by Genesee Towers. Because some in the community had made a commitment that it would be down, that it would be torn down by the time of the Crimm this year in 2013. It's unfortunate. You know, over the years, we've given tax breaks to General Motors for the Buick City Complex. Well, where's that at now? It's not. It's gone. Why is it that we give tax breaks to these companies, these organizations, and yet we do not give the tax break to the residents of Flint? When was the last time a company came into Flint and said, you know, instead of giving my company a tax break, why not just give a tax break to those employees who will be working at my company who will be living in Flint? What would that do? That would mean people would actually move into Flint. I'm almost at a loss of words. The city's master plan talks about closing some parks and letting them turn back to green spaces or whatever, or natural, thank you, natural places, because the city of Flint does not have the money. I mean, the whole world knows Flint does not have the money. Why would we now do this and give someone else a tax break? I mean, has anyone told us how many more jobs will be created because of this? Has anyone told us who actually owns the Capitol Theater and who will benefit? Who are the people, not the company, who are the people who will benefit from this tax break? Ask yourself this. Find out the answer. You'll be surprised to know or to learn. You know, I think this public hearing is just a thing for a process, just a thing for show. I believe the emergency financial manager has made up his mind. It's the same of so many other things that have happened in this community. So I'm against this district. I'm against the abatement. The people, you and I, and the residents of Flint cannot afford this. Thank you.
Is there anyone else that would like to address this public hearing? Is there anyone else that would like to address this public hearing?
I do have a couple questions when we close this hearing.
I had no intention of speaking. I guess the last few speakers coaxed my interest and maybe providing a few additional insights, and folks can decide the validity or worthiness of the argument. Before I do, may I be indulged, Claudia, Ms. Kroom, my friend, I appreciate your service. You're a good human being.
Thank you.
One of the finest people I've known. And I know you've done your best and tried to provide good service to the residents of the First Ward.
You're gonna make me cry.
And Belle, you're a good person. Okay, stop it.
Alex, oh.
Alex Harris, doesn't matter where I live. Other than in the city of Flint, proudly born here and resided here most of my life. Tax abatements. I'm not going to